This video is brought to you by Storyblogs Video.
It's Eric! Catch!
Rosa, catch!
Jordy, catch!
We'll catch!
Stop!
We need to clean, guys. Not play.
Okay.
Hey guys, it's Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome to Copycat Friday. Now it's not the first time that we got inspiration from Dude Perfect. Last time we threw a basketball from a large distance into the hoop. And although some people believe that we exposed Dude Perfect, well, no worries. What those guys do is 100% real. The reason that we're going to fake their trick shots is simply because we don't have the patience, so we use editing tricks. But first, a big shout out to our sponsor, Storyblogs Video, the number one tool that every filmmaker should have. It's an online library packed with high quality stock clips. You can find effects, there are title animations or logo intros, video effects like sparks and muzzle flashes, and so much more. Now I can just download as much as I want from this library without additional costs, which makes it so incredibly awesome. I can highly recommend to check it out too, which you can do by clicking the first link in the description below.
Instead of helping me, Lorenzo is just filming me.
Lesson 1. Never tuck the lift away before you're done with everything. I forgot the filters.
If you've been following us on Instagram, you know that we've been upgrading our studio lately. We're now able to control a bunch of lights on a ceiling system through a panel. It's all brand new, so we're still figuring out how it all works, but it's super awesome. Anyways, to pull off the effect that you saw in the intro, you don't need anything of that. Simply place your camera on a tripod and film yourself throwing an actual box. You can throw that box behind some other object, which will make it easier in post. Then step away from the shot to take an empty. And finally, throw that box on a place that you want it to land on. In Adobe After Effects, we're going to create a 3D model of that box. Now, don't get scared, it's actually super easy, as we're going to create a fake 3D model, also referred to as a 2.5D element. Here's how it goes. For starters, we need to take photos from our original box. You have to capture every side separately and make sure that you're at the same height as the box so that there's no perspective. And same goes for the lighting, make sure that it is flat. This means no shadows and no gradations. And now that you have shots of all the sides of the box, it's time to open up After Effects. Drag all 6 pictures into a new composition. Then select the layer on top and take the rectangle masking tool. It's important as you need a rectangle with perfect straight lines. Otherwise, you'll have gaps in the end on the 3D box. Okay, now that you have created your first mask on a side of the box, you go and search for the side that is parallel with the one that you already masked out. You can then copy the mask you already made and paste it onto the parallel side. Normally, if you made your pictures correctly, the mask will fit perfectly. Now do the same for the other two pair. First, create your mask on one side using the rectangle mask tool, and then copy and paste it to the parallel sides. If you have a perfect squared box, then you are lucky, as you can just copy and paste it 5 times. But with a long box, you have 3 pairs of different sides, so you'll need to create 3 different masks. When everything is masked out, select all the layers and turn them into a 3D layer from the layer options. And now it's time to make your box. With the X, Y, and Z controls, you can start rotating one layer 90 degrees. Hold down the Shift key while doing so to make them snap. Then you can push the layer on the X, Y, or Z axis, depending on which side that you're working on. Do this for every layer and try to create your box again. Never just move a layer around in that 3D space that we're working in right now. Always use the X, Y, and Z tools to do so. If you have trouble matching the different sides, you can set the view right here to 4 views. This will give you a clear look on every side of the box and makes it much easier to match everything together. When you're done, we're going to select all the layers, right-click and choose Pre-compose. Call it Box. Select Move all attributes into a new composition and then press OK. Now you have a box layer in your composition. Turn this also into a 3D layer and enable the star icon left to it from that 3D option. And this will help After Effects remember that it needs to take over the properties of the layers inside of that pre-comp layer. And that is all! Now you have yourself a nice looking 3D box which you can rotate and move around in the scene. Now, if it's all too much though, no worries. If you are new to Adobe After Effects, then definitely make sure to check out our beginners class. About 86% of the students told us that the class exceeded their expectations, which is truly awesome. I'll leave a link to the class in the description below. And now let's continue with the second half of the tutorial. We're going to start off with the animation of the box. Trim that layer onto the point where you throw the real box. At that point, create a keyframe for the position, scale, and all the rotation axes. Position your 3D box on the same way as the real box at this point. When that sits in place, move forward in time and use the real box to determine the change in rotation, position, and scale. Of course, we're going to define a new path, which is to Janik in this case. Then move forward in time and move the box over to the next target. If you click on the keyframe point in the composition window, you can also pull on a lever next to it, and this allows you to create an arc in the animation. Now, we added a little break in the animation by just letting the box float, but you can also just let it go directly to the final destination. When you're done, make sure to play your animation back a couple of times and adjust where needed. You want to try and make it appear as realistic as possible, of course. All right, now let's remove the real box. Take your empty shot and lay it on top of the normal shot. Disable the output of the empty shot for a moment, and then take the pen tool and draw a mask around the area where the real box should appear. After that, you can enable the layer back. You might want to create an animation for the mask path that you've just created. At the point where you decide to cut off the real box, you enlarge it there. And this way, the real box is gone immediately, instead of that it would fade away behind the mask. Now, where the box falls, it kind of works the exact same way. You take the shot of the real box falling, place that on top of the normal shot, take the mask tool and draw around it. We don't need to animate the mask this time, simply trim the 3D box and the real falling box so that you have a hard cut between them. Do make sure that their movement matches. And if everything went well, this is the result that we already have right now. But there's one last thing missing, which is light. The virtual box does not reflect the light from our studio, so we're going to have to recreate these lights in the virtual world as well. Now don't worry too much, we're only going to create two lights, which is already going to give us a natural look. Definitely for a box that is flying through the air. Head over to the menu, select Layer, New, and click on Light. For the light type, choose Spot, and then change the color to white, unless your actual light source also has a different color. And then hit OK. Now, since the biggest intensity of light comes from the top, we're also going to place that light over there. To do so, I'm going to change the view of the monitor again from one view to four views. And this will give me a top, a front, and a right view, which helps me to position the spotlight where I want it to be. Use the access points that we've seen before to put it in place. Now, chances are that your box is gonna stay dark, even though that the light does shine onto it. So dive into the layers options of the light and start off with increasing the fallout distance, which essentially means how far the light should cast. Increasing that should reveal your box. Furthermore, you can also change the cone size of the light, the feather of the edge of the light, and the intensity. Try to match those settings with the real lights from the shot. When you're done with that, we're going to go back to the menu, Layer, New, Light. This time choose Ambient under Light Type and change the color to white as well. And then hit OK. The ambient is going to take care for a global light. The only thing that you have to do here is change the intensity accordingly. The spotlight should be more intense than the ambient light. And now, the final touch. Since the box is flying through the air, I'm going to enable motion blur for the box layer by checking this box right here, and also enabling the global motion blur through this button. And now just render it out and enjoy the results.
And Janik, catch!
Where's the catch?
Turn again!
We'll catch! Stop! We need to clean, guys. Not play.
As you all know, I love to throw stuff at Janik, so that is why I just had to make a Janik Catch t-shirt, which you can find below the video. Thank you so much for watching, thank you Storyblocks for the support, and like always, stay creative.
This is perfect.
Allee, jongens, dat is toch de echte dude.